in a lonely moonlit valley, where man had seldom roamed, lived a rancher and his daughter. For years she made their home. For years she rode the ranges and knew every hidden trail. One place she loved to linger was by the silvery moonlight trail. Each night she'd go out riding when the moon was shining bright. When the moon peeped o'er the treetop, leaving the valley a silvery light. As she sat there on her pony and gazed at the trail afar, the stillness was suddenly broken by a voice and a strumming guitar. She sat a moment and listened. It came from the moonlit trail. She spurred her pony onward across the shadowy vale. There in that place she loved so well sat a cowboy humming a tune about a girl he longed to be with by the light of the silvery moon. Moonlight cast a shadow. There stood a maiden fair. The moonlight cast a silvery glow across her golden hair. Her face was like an angel. Her teeth were just like pearl. And then she smiled and I knew her. I had found my long-lost girl. So many times we wondered, when the moon was shining bright, I missed your smile, your loving eyes, as I sit alone tonight. It's been years since we parted. Our love has never failed. And now we're back together again by the silvery moonlight trail.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Folks, this is Frank Carver one more time, along with the rest of the band here, Country Classic, my brother Joe. I don't know if Joe is in the picture yet. And my good buddy Reg standing here on my left. Or on my right, pardon me, Reg, you were in my left, but you tricked me.
You're on my left.
Folks, today's show is, we're going to dedicate this program to a fellow who was born back in 1904 in a little village on the eastern shore of Nova Scotia. Went on to greater things, and he passed away on the 5th of December. Of course, I'm talking about the boy from Port Hilford, Nova Scotia, Wilf Carter. Today's program is proudly dedicated to the memory of Wilf Carter, somebody who I sort of grew up with, and I'm sure a lot of the folks here in the studio, a lot of the folks out there who are watching our show today will have fond memories of Wilf. You know, it was said of Wilf Carter that he played most of his songs on only three chords. And if you listen to his early music, I'm inclined to believe that. But this, friends, merely proves one thing, that you did not have to be a real terrific artist like my good buddy Reggie. But Wilf just got on up there, and he grabbed an old guitar, and I'm sure he touched the hearts of more than one person along the South Shore here. He had an unmistakable voice. Every song he's ever written told some type of a story of tragedy, of love, or of children, of dogs, of trains, you name it, Wilf was there. And there's one thing I don't think anybody can argue with, that he was the undisputed champion yodeler in the world. That's something nobody can convince me of anything else. I've heard him go, and he's just a marvel to listen to, and we're very sorry to hear about his passing, And if this show happens to touch any of his relatives, we don't very much will, but if it does, we send our deepest condolences from the band here on the stage and from management and staff here at the studio and also from his fans here gathered. So right now, we're going to do another one of Wilt's old tunes. It's called Dad's Little Texas Lad.
I'm just a Texas cowboy. I have not got a home. I was raised out on the prairie. Many deserts have I roamed. They say I had a sister who left when mother died. When I was just a little tot lying helpless by her side, I was raised by dear old daddy. They say he did his best. One day while trying to save me, the cattle tramped him to death. I'm going to tell a story as it was told to me by a lad called the Texas Ranger, who saw that big stampede. In the latter part of August, in the year of 1903, my dad took me out riding them longhorns for to see. While he was busy riding and I was playing around, a longhorn got excited, started pawing up the ground. They say Dad rushed to save me. His pony slipped and fell, and the cattle came in hundreds in their maddening rage to hell. Two guns flew off like lightning, two steers dropped in the lead. They were too close upon him to check them in their speed. When the dust had finally settled and the boys had gathered around, they gathered up a body that was trampled in the ground. There had been the horses and cattle dying of a fateful death. He gave his life to save me, his little Texas lad.
Thank you very much, studio audience. Thank you, folks out there at home. Thanks for tuning us in. We realize this is not a real opportune time to broadcast a show here in the studio. Everybody is probably straight out with Christmas shopping, and on Saturday afternoon, if you can spare the time, we'd like you to stick around. Leave that dial right where it is. Join the folks here in the studio. As I say, this is a bit of a memorial tribute to one of our own, a Nova Scotia boy who left the quiet little village of Port Hilford, went to the Annapolis Valley, picked apples, from there rode the rails out west, and the rest is history, so they say. Right now, I'm going to have to refer to a few notes here during the afternoon. Another one of Wilt's early songs, I remember my uncle singing this many years ago, and somehow I tried to get the record, couldn't get a hold of it, but I think I have the words together in the proper order. We're going to try The Dying Mother's Prayer.
There's a trail of lonely valley leading to a little home. There sits a mother brokenhearted, watching for her boy's return. I'll never forget the day he left me. I pleaded with him not to go. he was going to the city where the shining lights aglow. Soon fell in with bad companions way down in the sin of crime. First to drinking, then to gambling, they led that darling boy of mine. Then one night they planned a robbery, holding up the evening mail. But the plot was soon discovered, the gang was caught and put in jail. Behind steel bars for most a lifetime. Oh, 21 years is a long, long time. Each night I pray to God in heaven, oh, please bring back that boy of mine. I know that soon I will be going to dwell up in that heaven above. Each night I pray to God in heaven to please send back that boy I love. Then one night I watched the sunset coming up that winding trail. I saw a shadow in the valley a coming up that winding trail. Dear God, oh God, could my prayer be answered? Could it be my word first there? Thank God, my boy is returning. That was the dying mother's prayer. Thank you very much, studio audience. Thank you very much. We love that applause, mind you. Reggie told me in the way the other day, he said, boy, can those people ever clap. And we just love every bit of it. And you know, folks, being Christmas time, you know one thing about Reg here? Reg hung a stocking up. Department of Health made him take it down. How do you like that? All right. Okay, right now, this young fellow over here, and you know what's coming, don't you? This young fellow over here on my left, this is, I guess, my number one friend. If ever there was a guy who had a good brother, very proud of this kid. This is my little brother, Joe. My little brother, Joe. I know I'll catch you for that a bit later on. Joe, what about one of Wilf's little novelty numbers here? I'm ragged, but I'm right.
Sure.
Okay.
Well, I come here to tell you folks I'm ragged, but I'm right. I'm a tramping around here. I stay out late at night.
I'm in now, Reggie.
Three times a day. Just for my board, that's more than any loafer in this town can afford. Well, a big electric fan to keep me cool while I sleep. A little baby boy to play around at his feet. I'm a rambler, I'm a gambler, tell you, folks, I'm a ragged, but I'm right. I tell you, folks, I'm a ragged, but I'm right.
Hey, hey, all right. Okay, thanks a lot, Joe. Gotta love that one. That's one of his old standards. And we even had some of the folks here in the studio sing along with that one. And mind you, sounded just as good as this guy. Sounded real good out there, folks. Right now, we'd like to just take a moment to say hello to all our sick and shut-in friends, folks who maybe are not as lucky as we people here today to be able to get the studio, folks down in the Western Shore Senior Citizens Home, the Veterans Wing over in Lunenburg at the Fisherman's Memorial, the folks down at Shoreham and Chester, Bridgewater, Mahone Bay, Bridgewater, or anywhere else. And anywhere else that the folks may be tuned in, did we forget somebody? All right. we have another guy sitting over here. I tell you, this guy picks his spots. His spots are picked very carefully. This happens to be my Uncle Harry over here on the floor, and we'd like to say a big welcome to you, Uncle Harry. It's a real pleasure having you aboard today.
And it's all a pity.
Folks, as I say, I'm going to have to refer to the notes here today. We're going back in time, back to when Wolf Carter started to record on the old Bluebird record. That was the old RCA Victor Bluebird. And I remember years ago, I'm sure a lot of you will remember the old Western Airs program that was played on CHNS for many, many years. Jerry Parsons used to be the host in that one, and I guess about every 2 months, Jerry would run a contest. And you could bet your boots that the top two every time was either Carter and Snow or Snow and Carter. It was always in that order. Very seldom it changed. But here we had two native Nova Scotians, two of our own, who went on to world fame, and we are just so very proud of them. Just so very proud. Right now, we're going to back and dig out an old Wolf Carter, one of his old train songs, his old railroad songs. It's called The Rambling Hobo. For years I've been a rambler, no place I could call home. Always bumming from town to town, forever on the roam. The pouring rain is falling, there's not a train in sight. I guess I'll have to make my bed by the railroad tracks tonight. When at last through a cold gray dawning I hear a whistle shrill, around the bend she's coming, headed for the great uphill. I swing to board and I miss her, the speed has torn me loose. In one wild swing I grab again and I board that old caboose. Up stepped a stern conductor to put me off his train. He said, "You'll just a rounder, a railroad bum of fame." I looked at him and I said, "Sir, if you just let me explain, I'm sure you won't object to me riding on your train. You see, I left my home, sir, when I was just a boy, not old enough to know the ropes, that life was not all joy. Today I'm heading for my home, would not even know my dad. They say he is a railroad man, best pal a hobo had." The whistle broke the silence, the conductor looked and smiled, a teardrop fell from misty eyes. He said, thank God, and sighed. Your rambling days are through, my boy. You are my long-lost son. And when we hit that downgrade home, we'll both be on this run. Thank you. Thank you. Very kind. Thank you once again, you folks out there at home. Thanks for tuning us in today. Right now, got to go back to my notes again here. You know, everything is not total sadness, and such was the case with Wilf. Lived to the ripe old age of 91 years. And I can promise you folks one thing right now. If we can do anything to keep his type music alive here along the South Shore, we're going to do everything we can to do it. We're kind of stuck on traditional country music. Mind you, the modern music, it's beautiful. But when Wilf played, most of the time, him and a guitar, it was not until later years that he had a two- or three-piece band. But when you see guys today on TV, they've got a complete entire orchestra as well as a chorus with them. Wilf was alone with a guitar, and he made music that everybody just took him right to heart and loved him. And his music will live through the annals of time. Another thing I'd like to mention, another sad note, just a few days ago, the tragic passing of another terrific country artist who I had the pleasure of meeting him some years ago at the old Halifax Forum. Farron Young. Now, one of our cameramen here today, Doug, brought a photo album in, and he showed us some real treasured memories. Doug had quite an audience with Farron a few years back, and Farron invited Doug down to his home, told him exactly where to go, but Doug passed up the opportunity, and I kind of think Doug feels a little bit sorry about that today. It was an opportunity that probably presents itself once in a lifetime. I had the opportunity of meeting Wilf on two occasions. The most recent was some years ago when he did a show at the old Halifax Forum. My wife and I were backstage with him, and truthfully, friends, I never met a more personal, more loving, more tender soul, more wonderful person. I mean, here's this huge giant of a man, a guy right from our own midst. And when this guy cracked a smile, it was just the same as somebody hung another sun up there. The smile just went from one side to the other. Never in a hurry. You want to talk to him, he was there. We're going to miss you, Wilf, but we're not going to forget your music, buddy. I'll tell you that right now. Okay, here's another one of Wilf's that he had a bit of fun with this one. Some of you folks may relate to this one. Some of you folks at home, if you do, don't hesitate to sing along with it. Last summer I thought I would go to the country, spend my vacation, get a much-needed rest. One morning I went to the well for some water. Folks told me that drinking well water was best. I had a red patch on the seat of my trousers, and when I leaned over, it exposed her to view. Never believing of leaving that old-time tradition, but I soon found out that these sayings were true. Now a bull that was grazing at the red patch stood gazing. Now in such a case, what would any bull do? Gave a great feller, then headed straight for me. That little red patch I exposed there to view. We ran through the pasture, but he ran the faster, and I realized I'd be doomed if I fell. So in a great fright, I turned back to the right and headed straight back to that old covered well. There I thought I could hide by climbing inside. until my pursuer could forget the rule. But when I reached for the bucket, then his horns, they struck it. That little red patch I exposed there to view. So in my last hope, I reached out for the rope, and down in that old-fashioned bucket I fell. I got a good drink of water, but I feel kind of sorter that all the swell water, what ain't all so swell. Hey, quite an experience. That just goes to show you. I see some of you folks out here with red jackets on today. So you want to check the fields outside. Make sure there's not a bull out there when you go outside. Hey, you could be in real trouble. Friends, right after this next tune, we're going to take a brief break, and we would ask you to stay tuned. I understand the boys out in the control room want to drop a tape on, and we're going to be just take a 15-minute breather, at which time we're going to be right back with the second part of our live show. Right now, Brother Joe, one of my favorite tunes, a Wolf Carter tune that received quite a bit of attention on his way up. It's called Just a Woman's Smile.
Just a woman's smile, a kiss and a sigh, and the world has turned me down. Just a woman's smile, a kiss and a sigh, and the world has turned me down. For just a moment's pleasure, I lost my happiness. The dear ones that I treasure, I'll never see, I guess. Just a woman's smile, a kiss and a sigh, and the world has turned me down.
Reggie Kirwan.
Is once again a tribute to the late Wolf Carter, who passed away on the 5th of December. We're going to go into our second half here with some more of Wolf's tune, and we understand that my brother Joe is also going to pay a brief tribute to the late Farron Young, who passed away just 3 years ago. So without further ado, we're going to walk right into this one. There's a husky, dusty maiden in the Arctic. In her igloo, she's waiting there in vain. So I guess I'll put my mud plucks on and ask her if she'll wed me when the ice worm nests again. In the land of the pale blue snow, where it's 99 below, and the polar bears are roaming o'er the plain. In the shadow of the pole, I will clasp her to my soul. We'll be happy when the ice worm nests again. Reggie, man! least would be seal oil and blubber. In our kayak we'll roam the boundless main. All the walruses will turn their necks to rubber. We'll be happy when the ice worm nests again. In the land of the pale blue snow, where it's 99 below, and the polar bears are roaming o'er the plain. In the shadow of the pole, I will prosper to my soul. We'll be happy when the ice worm nests again. Do me one more, Reggie. All those blinking icebergs bound around us, she'll present me with a bouncing baby boy. All the polar bears will dance the rumba around us, and the walruses will click their teeth with joy. In the land of the pale blue snow, where it's 99 below, and the polar bears are roaming o'er the plain. In the shadow of the pole, I will prosper to my soul. We'll be happy when the ice worm nests again. Do me just one more. The pale blue snow, where it's 99 below, and the polar bears are roaming o'er the plain. In the shadow of the pole, I will prosper to my soul. We'll be happy when the ice worm nests again. Okay, thanks a lot, studio audience. Folks, during that break, that old telephone out there wasn't quiet for one moment. And we want to thank all you good folks at home for taking time out of your busy day to give us a buzz here at the studio. We really appreciate it. Before we forget it, this being the Yule season, I know we've done it in our Christmas show, but one more time from Classic Country, all staff and management here at the studio, we hope that this may be your best, safest, and happiest Christmas yet. That is a sincere hope from management staff, all the folks here at the studio, that goes out to you too. Right now, we'd like to say a special hello to a couple of our old buddies who are not able to be here today. George and Frida, I can see you sitting right by your set there now, George. Thanks to you and Frida for your phone call and your best wishes. Also, a special hello to my wife, who is visiting in the studio today, to my wife, Dorothy. She's out in the control room right now. I don't think she wanted the camera to be on her. But a big welcome to you, babes. We're glad to have you with us. And I have a daughter at home, a little grandson, and another daughter. I call them the three L's, Lynn, Luke, and Lori. A special hello to them. Also to Kenny, Holly, and my two boys down in Brookside. So right now, folks, here's another one of Wilf's that goes back a long way. It's one, the very first time I heard it, I really loved the tune. And I think we did it on the show probably 3 or 4 months back. We'd like for you to give a listen to it today again. It's simply called Thinking. I was feeling sad and lonely while strolling in the park. I came upon a lonely bench. It was hidden in the dark. The wind was blowing gently. The stars shone overhead. the night bird sang above me, no sweeter could be read. I was thinking of my mother, the dearest pal I had. Could I think of another dear one? Well, I might have said my dad. Dear mother has departed to the place where good souls go. And as I sat with thoughts of her, the tears would come and go. The sun has risen, and I've slept the whole night through. So I'll stroll back where I came from, mother, thinking still of you. This whole world seems so lonely now that you have gone. When the roll is called up yonder, may we meet in that great beyond. I was thinking of my mother, the dearest pal I had. Could I think of another dear one? Well, I might have said my dad. Dear mother has departed to the place where good souls go. And as I sat with thoughts of her, the tears would come and go. Thinking, one of the early favorites of Wilf Carter. Right now, folks, in remembrance of Farron Young, our cameraman, who was a very big fan of Farron Young, apparently he was talking to Brother Joe during the intermission, and Joe has consented to do a tune especially for Doug. So, Joe, if you would, please.
It's 4 in the morning, and once more the dawn just woke up the wanting in me. Wishing I'd never met her, knowing if I'd forget her, how much better off she would be. The longer I hold on, the longer it goes on, the harder that it's gonna be. It's 4 in the morning and once more the dawn just woke up the wanting in me. Last night I told her this time it's all over, the 10th time I've told her. Last night we broke up, this morning I woke up, for the 10th time I'm changing my mind. I saw more love in her eyes when I left her than most foolish men will ever see. It's 4 in the morning and once more the dawn just woke up the one. Thank you.
last night I told her this time it's all over. Make it 10 times I've told her goodbye. Last night we broke up. This morning I woke up. For the 10th time I'm changing my mind. I saw more love in her eyes when I left her than most foolish men will ever see. It's 4 in the morning and once more the dawning just woke up the warning in me. It's 4 in the morning and once more the dawning just woke up the warning in me.
Thank you.
That's got to be one of the finest tunes that was ever written. That's a tune that I have loved ever since the first time I've heard it. It's a Farron Young standard. I think it's one that sold more records for him than any other record he had ever put on wax. Right now, back to our tribute to the late Wilf Carter. Here's another one that Wilf, many years ago, sang with nothing more than just a flat-top guitar. It's called Blue Skies.
Hear the lowing of the cattle floating o'er the gentle breeze as the cowhands slowly ride along the trail. All the prairie seems to murmur, all the gray skies roll away. She's my pretty little blue skies from the vale. She's my blue skies filled with sunshine. Blue skies mean all the world to me. She's my blue sky way out yonder. My gray skies have turned blue. When you hear me softly calling on the prairie, calling from the prairie crest, she's my blue sky filled with sunshine. I'm calling to the one I love the best.
Rich, try it one time.
At last the rays of sunset bids the golden plains good night, and the stars play hide and seek amid the blue. It is then my thoughts will wander of old memories sweet to dream. Good night, blue skies, and pleasant dreams to you. She's my blue skies way out yonder. Blue skies mean all the world to me. She's my blue sky filled with sunshine. My gray skies have turned to blue. When you hear me softly calling from the prairie, calling from the prairie crest, she's my blue sky filled with sunshine. I'm calling to the one I love the best.
Thank you, friends. So very glad you enjoyed that one. We'd like to say another special hello to a couple of folks down on Western Shore. Wilma and Roy, I hope you're watching in. Also, my cousin Joy, I dare not forget her, one of my biggest critics, and my other cousin Margie. I know they're tuned in. They very seldom miss one of our shows. So we look forward to probably seeing you over the holidays and wishing you a Merry Christmas in person. But right about now, we're going back again in the Wolf Carter vein. A bunch of jolly cowboys, when roundup time was done, decided they would head for town to have a little fun. As they rode gaily down the trail, you could hear the old cook say, "I'll hang the key on the bunkhouse door. Now, boys, don't you be late. Hang the key on the bunkhouse door. We'll be late tonight. Don't leave the light a-burning, dear. We may not look right. The trail is long, the going's tough, and someone may get tight. So hang the key on the bunkhouse door, and we'll be late tonight. No, city gals are lots of fun, but they can't see our way. Swinging through the old square dance, they call us ornery strays. All dressed in chaps and jingling spurs, we sang with all our might. Hang the key on the bunkhouse door, 'cause we'll be late tonight. Hang the key on the bunkhouse door, we'll be late tonight. Don't leave the light a-burning, dear, we may not look right. The trail is long, the going's tough, someone may get tight. So hang the key on the bunkhouse door, 'cause we'll be late tonight."
Tell me one time.
Bunkhouse door, we'll be late tonight. Don't leave the light a-burning, dear, we may not look right. The trail is long, the going's tough, someone may get tight. So hang the key on the bunkhouse door, 'cause we'll be late tonight.
Thank you very much, folks. Thanks. Just one more thing, ladies and gentlemen. When you're doing a live show, it's an awful lot different than when you have the advantage of erasing a tape and going back over it. So any mistakes that we make here today, we want you to just put tongue in cheek and bear with us. I guess to quote a saying today, what you see is what you get. So as long as you're having a bit of fun helping us remember, we appreciate it. Right now, I got to go back to my notes one more time. I guess of all the tunes Wolf Carter ever wrote, I think the one that the people in Nova Scotia remember him for the best. It's sort of a tragedy type thing. I shouldn't say sort of a tragedy. It was a tragedy. It happened down at Moose River on an Easter Sunday. It brought just attention from all over the world. There were reporters, newsmen, everything else. And in that day and age, we had to depend, well, I shouldn't say me, I don't think I can remember it. But most people then were tuned in to an old battery radio. Electricity was a scarcity, not too many around, but I think everybody in Canada, US, and everywhere else were just tuned in to hear what happened to those men imprisoned far, far in that mine with no contact. We would like to try and do that tune for you here today. It's called The Rescue from Moose River Gold Mine.
Way down in old Nova Scotia, Moose River, it seems, is the name. Three Canadians on Easter Sunday, to the tumble-down gold mine they came. They descended the mine for inspection, never dreaming fate trailed them close by. Till a crash that gave them no warning, entombed in that mine there to die. Brave men from all over the country volunteered to give up their lives, They slaved with unceasing efforts. It seemed that death they defied. Long days and nights they had labored, turned back when great cave-ins fell, while far below patiently waiting, three men were in one living hell. Many times turned back when they're rescued, fate seemed always blocking their way. With a prayer on their lips, they worked onward. We must win, pray we may. On Sunday, they got the first message from the men prisoned far, far below. Can you help us? They heard a voice calling. Our suffering God above only knows. Next message filled all hearts with sorrow when we heard them say one pal is gone. We are trying our best to hold on, boys. Do your best, don't make it too long. At last, a great strain, it was broken. A miner out of breath brought the news. We have won the great fight he was calling. At last, we have dug our way through. That great fight against the dark angel, it is one fighting hard all the way. Still a tragedy came with the rescue from the tomb of those terrible days. Now friends, my story is ending with hardships of many a day. But this rescue will go down in history of the gold mine down Moose River Way. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. You know, my brother Joe, who works for another TV station, had the opportunity to work with Wolf Carter, and I would like to ask Joe to just give you some of his views on this marvelous person.
Well, I met Wolf Carter back many years ago. Well, yeah, quite a few years ago. Wolf was living down in Florida at that time, and he came up to do some shows in Halifax, and it all happened at the old Olympic Gardens. And Wolf kind of had his own way of playing a guitar, and he just kind of did his thing, and the band would just kind of fumble and try to follow him, and he just became a real favorite of everybody that came out to see him. And when Wolf went back to Florida, he sent us all up, sent the crew, the TV crew, a whole bunch of oranges and cards and thank yous and everything else. So he's he was just quite a great guy. So I was very pleased to meet Wolf.
Thank you very much, Joe, for those fine words. Folks, I'm just checking the time here, and it looks like we're just about out of time for today. Let us thank, we just have a line of people right around here that ever look good. It looks real good. How are you, Mom? You enjoying the show? Thanks for coming on over. But on this tribute today, folks, we hope that you will help us keep traditional country music alive here along the South Shore, as well as anywhere else in Nova Scotia. We want to thank each and every one of you for being here. We want to thank you, especially at home, for leaving that dial right where it was for about the last hour. On behalf of Classic Country, one more time, we want to take this opportunity to wish you one more time the same old time honored wish, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Right now, Wolf, being a God-fearing man, every now and then he would record an album of sacred songs. One of Wolf's favorite songs was one that you all know, and it won't hurt at all if you join in right here in the studio or you folks at home. I'm going to ask Brother Joe to do the Old Rugged Cross.
I would just like to say I have the words here, thanks to Barb, who supplied me with a beautiful hymn book a few months back, and the reason I'm using the words is because Sis corrected me the last time I did this, and I guess I had some of the words wrong, so I'll try to get it right this time. Reggie, you got an intro for it? Key of A?
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross with the dearest and best, for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my truth. So despised by the world as a wondrous attraction for me, for the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear.
Oh,
Job well done. Job well done. Thank you, studio audience, for joining in on that. You sounded real good. Well, folks, it looks like this is the end of another show. So until we see you next time early in the new year, this is Frank Carver on behalf of Brother Joe, my good buddy Reg, management and staff here at the studio, on behalf of my wife who was in the control room, and behalf of this wonderful studio audience, saying until next time, so long, good luck, and may God bless you.